Is email dead? And if not, what are some tips to keep it alive? Stay tuned and find out.
Okay, here's the question.
Are you serious?
How are we dark horses? You know, the ones everyone is betting against, the ones they don't expect to win, place, or even show on the track, and they'll even laugh on us when we talk about trying. How do we show the world our greatness and triumph?
Come on.
Well, that's the question, and this podcast will give you the answers. This is The Dark Horse Entrepreneur. My name is Tracy Brinkman.
And push it up.
What is up? What is up? What the hell is up, my dark horse friends and family? Welcome back to another live episode where you're going to get a lot more of the Lord of Emails learning today. I'm your dark horse host, Tracy Brinkman, and you, well, my friend, that is infinitely more important. You are a driven entrepreneur or one in the making. Either way, you're here because you're ready to start, restart, kickstart, just start leveling up with some great personal marketing or business tips and results in order to build that beautiful business of yours into the empire it absolutely deserves to be. And that's why I'm here coming to you with another daily success episode where we see dive deep into success with some actionable advice, tips, and steps to help you level up your game, because we know there are no shortcuts to success except for taking those little steps towards your goal every single day. Now, I hope you're getting value from these episodes, and if you are, drop us a little like down below, give us a thumbs up, some kind words in the comments, and obviously if you're listening to this on the podcast, then go ahead and hit us up on the subscribes and the ratings, put some kind words in the reviews. That lets those podcast platforms out there know that you're getting that value. They lift us up a little bit in the rankings so that we can reach more driven entrepreneurs just like you. Hey, hello, how's it going? It doesn't say who you are. You have to click that little link that should be showing up in the notes so that it will show me your name here in StreamYard that I'm using to record this live episode. Now, we talked with Tom Antey on Monday, and obviously he was a big fan of emails. He's been building an email list, I think he said, of 100,000 users. It's reached the heights of 150,000. And I remember back on episodes, I'm looking at my notes here, 119, 120, and 121, we went into a lot of tips and tricks and techniques about emails. But so I don't want to rehash all that, so be sure to go back and check out those episodes. And I'm happy to have you here, by the way. But I do want to kind of glaze over some of them and give you a new one, which is, you know, the email kind of is that one ring to rule them all. Obviously, I'm a Lord of the Rings fan. But let's go through, that's about seven tips we got here. And I think one thing to remember when it comes to emails is that each element of the email should do one job. I mean, I've seen so many folks use emails and try to do so many things in each one of the elements that they end up really not accomplishing anything at all. So if we break these down into the two key elements, one is the subject line. And the only job of the subject line in an email is to get them to open that email up. That's it, right? Don't be trying to pitch them in the subject line or anything else. You want to catch their eye, make them go, I wonder what he's talking about here. You know, pique their curiosity, get them to open the email. Then in the body of the email, the job of the body of the email is to get them to click the link to take them to tell them the rest of the story. So you want to obviously take that interest you've piqued, build on it, engage them some more, and then, you know, share some information and then get them to click through on the link. And that leads right into tip number two I want to share with you today is keep it short and sweet. We don't need these long dissertations. I think there are times when that will make sense. But so many times you see some, you know, there's folks that they just do these long emails over and over and over again. I don't know about you, but I don't read them all. Now, I do have one marketer that emails me, and they're usually very short and succinct, and they make sense. A couple of paragraphs, drive to the point. You want to know more? Here's the link. Bing, bang, boom. But when they send me a long one, it's like, okay, this is different. All right. And I'll read a little further, and then they make sense. So if you're going to do that, do it infrequently. And then make sure it makes sense. And then the next thing is you want to train your subscribers to click the link. And the best way to do that is to have a link in every email, right? If you just, you know, you send an email every once in a while and you never put a link in, all of a sudden there is a link. Well, they're like, oh, I don't want to click that, right? So if every email has a link, right, to get more information, to share more of the story and what have you, then they're trained to go ahead and click on that link. Now, a great way to do this is by sharing stories and then saying, ah, if you'd like to know the conclusion, you got to click that link, right? Or if you want to know what happened, you got to click that link. Or if you want to know how to keep this from happening to you, you get it. Click the link, right? And then the next one comes up with, as you're doing these emails, you're going to want to be consistent. And that doesn't have to be every single day, but whatever schedule you're on, right? Ka-chunka, 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 ka-chunka. That way when they see your name, they're like, oh, I know this. This is Tracy. He's got this email and I'm going to check it out. And yeah, I probably won't hear from him again for a week. And boom, don't send out an email and then wait 6 weeks to send out another one, because sometimes people get blasted with so many emails like, who is this guy? Delete, right? You know, and I think another good thing about consistency is consistency breeds familiarity. You like how my tongue just tripped over my eye teeth? I couldn't see what I was saying. Familiarity breeds comfort, and comfort breeds trust, right? So you want to keep that consistency. If that's once a week, if that's twice a week, you know, you're going to send them something on Tuesday and Friday, whatever it is, keep going. And then as you're able to, especially with the technology we have nowadays, personalize. As you get little bits of information personalized, at least their name, right? Bam, I'm going to drop this in here. And so instead of it saying, hey, user, right? It says, hey, Tracy, hey, John, hey, Jane. So it just brings them in a little bit more. And then segment your list, right? So as you build your list, sometimes they came in through this channel via maybe your lead magnet. Maybe they came in through your podcast. Maybe they came in through you just engaging with you. Different avenues means they have different core likes, different reasons they came on board. And then as you segment that, you can focus your emails towards that group of folks. So I know for me, I'll have two group of folks right now. One group of folks that are really focused on podcast guesting, and then another group of folks that are really focused on podcast hosting. Now, could they cross over? Absolutely, right? But as a core message, I want to focus on what their key interest in. And then last but not least, certainly you want to tell story as much as you can. Be the storyteller. Okay, got another Lord of the Rings fan in the audience listening to us. Absolutely. What a great movie. And I read the books way back when I was young. I turned them turned my daughters onto them, bought them a set of the entire trilogy. And I know the pages were worn thin. But anyway, so that's a great example of telling stories, right? Those stories, you can read those stories over and over and over again. And at different times in your life and whatever experience you're going through, something different will catch your attention. So you may be telling this great story. And I know here's a great story for me. Way back when I first got into the digital marketing space, and I'm, you know, as you can tell by the long gray beard, I've been a little long in the tooth in the marketing arena. It was Thanksgiving, and I had sent out my weekly email earlier in the week already. I think I did them on Tuesdays and Fridays, which is why I mentioned it earlier, right? And so obviously Thanksgiving's on a Thursday, and there was just this moment that happened during Thanksgiving. My kids were sitting down, right? And I just got finished making the turkey. My mom and dad were over. It was just, this vibe was in the air. It was so cool. And I walked over to my computer, and I typed up an email, and I shared this message of gratitude for what I was looking at across the dinner table. And, you know, I just wanted to share that with my email list. No pitches, no nothing, just sharing this story and hoping that they had an amazing day before them as well. And that was one of my most read emails. I got the most reactions out of it. And that kind of leads into where I was going with these last four exercises I want to share with you. And the number one exercise is show gratitude, right? That giving of thanks, you know, and how they made an impact. You know, I was sharing in that email about how my mom and dad had impact in my life, how my kids had impact. And it doesn't have to be the reader of the email that you're thankful for, right? They're reading your gratitude. They're identifying with you as a person. They're connecting with you. It could be a teacher you're talking about. It could be a lost friend. In my case, it was my kids and my mom and dad. Tell them how it made you feel amazing. And you're helping impart that amazing feeling onto them, right? Builds that connection with your list. And that is an amazing way to bond with folks. And again, I'm not sharing these tips in an effort to make you manipulative, right? I'm sharing these, yes, definitely feel, please message me and let's connect. So in the chat here, and I can't see their name, said they were going to be messaging me. And anyone listening to this before or after, please feel free to hit me up on emails, tracy@darkhorseschooling.com, or on Facebook or on LinkedIn. You know, I am happy to connect with folks and help in any way I can. And that leads right in to the next exercise I want to share with you is ask for help. Hey, I have a question. I need some assistance. You know, open yourself up. There's so much wisdom and untapped knowledge out there. The list of people you have on your email have such a diverse set of backgrounds, I can almost guarantee it. And trust me, they'll be flattered that you're asking for the help, and they might even provide you some insights that could change your life or change your business. Plus, and you've heard me say this, you always want to be listening to your tribe anyway, right? So it's a great way to get valuable tips and insights on how you can better serve them. But at the same time, you know, you're showing, you know what? I'm human, just like you. I'm just like you, which is one of the great connectors. Another exercise here is to do something unexpected, right? I think the key here is to develop something openly and creatively. You know, maybe you put yourself in their shoes and think about it for a minute. What kind of challenges are they going through right now? And how can you help them with that challenge? And just give it to them, right? Remember we talked about this earlier this week, I believe it was, you know, do something valuable and give it away. People will be lining up with take my money, please. Because they're like, if this is what he's giving away, how amazing is his service that I pay for, right? And again, I'm not sharing these things to be manipulative. I'm sharing them because as you put more out, you get more back. It's karma, right? Okay. And maybe there's somebody out there who's, I don't know, having trouble with their emails. And maybe there's someone out there having troubles making that first sale or, you know, making a connection. And you figure out, here's how I can help them. Put it out there. Hey, I know Jake could help John. And let me tell you all about Jake. And you send that email out and folks going, oh my God, that's what I needed. And then they want to come. And then there's that whole thing about reciprocity. Come all the way around. And I think finally, and this is one that could be challenging, and hear me out, expressing an opinion. I get it. There are so many opinions out there. They're like buttholes. We all have one. Some of us have multiple opinions. But I'm not talking about expressing an opinion in order to convince someone to come over on your side. I'm talking about building up your skills in communication, in leadership, that you can express your opinion in such a way that you're sharing without offending, right? You don't have to say, you know what, I think McDonald's is the greatest restaurant on the planet, and if you don't think so, you're a jerk, you're a butthead, you're an asshole, whatever it is. You don't have to be like. You can express what it is you like about something without putting forth the thought that if you don't agree with me, you're a jerk. You know what I'm saying? So expressing opinion is certainly a great way to start a dialogue. I know my former sister-in-law was polar opposite to me when it came to political views, but we were able to have some amazing conversations because neither one of us were trying to force our opinions upon the other. It was like, hey, this is what I think. This is what you think. Well, I never thought about it that way. You know, so you can have that dialogue, that exchange. And if one of you moves your needle one way or the other, fine. If you don't, fine. It's okay. But express an opinion. Here's the thing, or especially when it comes to your email list, having an opinion. You know, don't be all milquetoast, wishy-washy, right? I don't know. What do you think? No, have an opinion. And if you don't have an opinion, share why you don't have an opinion. Well, I've never tried it. I've never used that service. I don't know that person. So I really can't share an opinion. If you've heard something good, bad, or ugly, just share it like that. But have an opinion and be willing to express it. Here's the fun thing when it comes to emails. You're going to have to go through Minas Ithil to get to your Middle Earth, and you don't have a Gandalf to guide you, right? Oh, well, maybe you do. I mean, yeah, I do have the beard, yeah? Anyway, learn to control that one ring of email that can control them all in a way that you know will help them by getting them to open up the email with the subject, by giving to your tribe, by expressing your opinion so that you can reap the rewards greater than any dragon's treasure. Yeah? All right, my Dark Horse friends and family. Tomorrow, we're going to be chatting about social media trends that you're definitely going to keep an eye on. All right, until next time, or actually, until tomorrow, I'm going to leave you as I always do. Think successfully and take action.
Thank you for listening to the Dark Horse Entrepreneur Podcast.
And you know this!
Thanks for tuning in.
Check us out at www.darkhorseschooling.com.
All right.
My name is Tracy Brinkman.